My journey began when I inherited a box full of my mother's family history. I had always known about my great-grandfather, Peter Henderson Bryce, but the information she gathered hinted at a much greater story.
Peter Bryce rose from humble beginnings to become one of the most powerful men in Ontario by the time he was 30 years old. He shaped public policy and had a major impact on the public health of all Canadians by writing and enforcing important but often controversial laws. But then he discovered appalling conditions at Canada's Indian residential schools, and his work caused official embarrassment in government. Under the direction of Duncan Campbell Scott, Bryce was shuffled out of his job and forced to retire. I start on a journey with the hope of finding out something about me and about where I come from. I want to know why my father and his sister never really talked about Peter Bryce. I want to know more about a family I know little about. Along the way, I traveled to a village in Ontario to find Peter Bryce's childhood home. I traveled to a cabin in Muskoka to meet 40 other descendants. And then I traveled to Toronto to meet a philanthropist and physician who donates $10 million to establish the Waukepinis Bryce Indigenous Health Institute. And finally, I participate in a naming ceremony and speak on behalf of my family.
It is a tremendous honor that Peter Bryce's name is on this institute, and we, the Bryce family, deeply appreciate the recognition. This is a moving occasion for us, and on behalf of all of the descendants of Dr. Peter Bryce, we thank you from our hearts.